Is evolution a fact, a theory, or just fake science? Good day, everyone. To judge whether evolution is actually a fact or a theory, we need first to understand what is the meaning of a fact and what is the meaning of a theory. In very simple words, a fact is like when you say an apple falls to the ground. It's an observation. A theory is like when somebody says the apple is falling to the ground because there is a force that I'm going to call gravity, and it depends on the mass of the apple and the mass of the earth and the inverse square of the distance between them. Now, for this to qualify as a theory, there needs to be enough observations that support this calculation, and it should be tested, and those tests need to be repeatable. So if Isaac Newton, in this case, would go into his lab and says, I tried all these different objects with those masses and the force generated was that much, I can go to my lab and generate the same results. So we wouldn't take his word for it. So we need observations. Those observations need to be repeatable. Now, a very important property of theories is that we can use them to make predictions. So we say, for example, according to the theory, if we have a rocket at that mass and we want to make it project outside of the Earth's gravity, it needs to go at that speed, and we use the theory to do the calculation. And guess what? If we give it enough power, it will generate the force to take it out of the Earth's gravitational field. We don't waste, in this case, 100 rockets to get to the right figure. We can use the theory. So the power of theories is that we can use them to make predictions. Now, let's look at the claim of evolution. Of course, there are no observations that are repeatable. None of us has seen a whale change to a cow. None of us has seen a chimp change to a human being, or any animal autonomously change to any other animal or any other creature. So evolutionists will reply to this that, okay, it needs so much time, and there is the fossil record, which is what we're going to do separate episodes about it, because this is really not evidence at all. But then let's see if the theory of evolution can really make predictions. And one very easy prediction is us. Can the theory of evolution predict human being existence? Now, the theory of evolution of species starts from the very first cell and says that life will gradually and very, very slowly evolve into more complex creatures, ending with the human being. It says that this process is totally blind and totally random and depends on completely unguided processes of nature, like mutations, and those mutations would generate different versions of the creature, and then the right version, which has a better chance of survival, would be picked by natural selection. Now, we're going to make episodes on those claims, whether mutation and natural selection can actually do this work. But let's assume that this is okay and see if the observations that we see around us would be consistent with the predictions of this theory. So let's ask this question. How come we have human beings? Why am I asking this question? Because human beings have those features that are unbelievably advanced versus their next most advanced creature. How come human beings have language? A great diversity of language. Language that has things like poetry. Language that's not only spoken, but written. Language that transfers knowledge, not only between people, but across generations. Language that's written on caves, on temples, and in books. Since there is a very clear advantage for having language, how did only humans generate this feature? Humans are very new, according to the claims of paleontologists. There are other creatures on Earth that are many, many, many millions and hundreds of millions of years here on Earth before humans. How come none of them has language, even if it's a little bit inferior than humans? So this is one question. Another question, the most important things that makes a human distinct from a non-human is this, the ability of humans to reason, human intellect. And it's very obvious that having this kind of intellect, intelligence, has a very obvious survival advantage. So how come we don't have thinking sharks? How come we don't have thinking cats and dogs? At least one species of cats and dogs and sharks should be thinking as good as us, because other features that do have survival advantages, like being able to swim, like being able to fly, are common between so many species. We have flying animals, mammals like bats, we have flying birds, we have flying insects, we even have flying fish. How come we don't have any thinking creature except for human beings? And how come the next creature is so far away in terms of intellect versus humans? How come, hence, there is only one civilization on the face of the planet, which is human civilization? Because they don't have language and they cannot think, of course. And hence, the theory predicts that there is gradual evolution, but it fails to explain how humans exist. So let's look at this. We have this theory. It says, I can explain to you from the very first form of life until the very last one. It fails to explain how this very first form of life came to existence. Someone will claim it's out of its scope. And it also fails to explain how this form of life exists. And in between, there is no evidence. There is no observations. It is unobservable. Does it make sense to call this a theory? I would call it a false claim. What would you call it? Thank you.